Jesus said, so likewise, if you do not repent, you're going to perish. That means you're going to go to hell if you do not get right with God. That means if you do not come to the mercy seat of the Lord Jesus Christ and humble yourself, you're going to go to hell. And God doesn't want people to go to hell. So he sends preachers out here to warn you not to go to hell, not to live a hypocritical life and name the name of Jesus, yet you live like the world. The Bible says that these men, these people, they honor Jesus with their mouth, but their hearts are far from him. And this is how many people are. They say Jesus, Jesus, that they believe in God, but they live like the world. They live in sin. They practice sexual immorality. They live in drunkenness. And they smoke weed. And they say they believe in God. And the Bible says that if you do not repent, you're going to go to hell. God calls that hypocrisy. That's what that is. And the Bible says that all hypocrites will have their part in the lake of fire that burns with fire and brimstone. My friends, we can't be hypocrites. God is serious about his salvation. God says that if you do not repent and if you do not humble yourself and depart from iniquity, you're going to go to hell. It's all in the Bible, my friends. Yet you have to open the Bible and get real with God and stop playing games. Turn away from your sinful living. The Bible says that let those who name the name of Christ depart from iniquity. That means you got to stop living unholy and ungodly, because there is a day of judgment coming. The Bible says you're going to stand before God and you're going to give an account for your life. And without the salvation of the Lord, sir, you're going to go to hell. That's what's going to happen to you. And God doesn't want people to go to hell. God's delight is that people repent and come to the Lord Jesus Christ. Yet men don't want to come to God. They want to live their life ungodly. They want to live their life without God ruling over their lives. And they live in rebellion, and because of that, they die and they go to hell. This is the judgment for those who choose to live ungodly and unholy. It's hell, my friends. And when you go to hell, there's no second chances in hell. When you die and you go to hell, that's it. When you die in this life without the salvation of God, sir, you go to hell. And when you go to hell, there's no Bibles in hell. There's no second chances in hell. There's no preachers preaching to you in hell to tell you to get right with God, because it's too late. You done rejected the mercy of God if you open your eyes up in hell. If you find yourself in hell, ma'am, it's because you rejected God's salvation and you chose to live for yourself. And you said, I don't want nothing to do with Jesus. And we live in a world where men and women, they reject the salvation of God. And there's going to be hell to pay for all those who reject God's salvation. There's going to be hell to pay for all those who choose to continue living on in their rebellion. Yet while you are still alive, you can come to God and get your heart right with the Lord. While you are still alive, ma'am, you can repent. The Bible commands that all men everywhere should repent, because God has appointed a day of judgment where he is going to judge all those who are living in rebellion. He's going to judge you, sir. You put up the window on the preacher, but there's coming a day you won't be able to put up the window on God. Judgment day is coming for you, sir. There is a day of accountability. And men, they try to run from the preaching of God's word. They don't want nothing to do with God because they rebels in their hearts. They are living in rebellion, so they try to stay as far away from the Bible as they can because they want to live in rebellion. It's like the drug dealer. When he sees a cop, he goes the other way because in his heart he knows he's breaking the law. And it's the same with the rebellious sinner. They don't want to come to the Bible and commit to the Lord. They don't want to hear nothing about Jesus. When they hear the Bible being preached, they go the other way. They put the window up because they don't agree with God's laws. They don't agree with God's word. Because God's word says, live holy. He says, be ye holy, for which I am holy. But the rebellious sinner doesn't want to live holy. They want to live unholy and ungodly. And because of that, they stay away from the Bible. They run from the preaching of God's word. Yet there is coming a fearful day of judgment where there will be no running anymore. Your time of running from God is almost over, my friends. For it is appointed once for man to die, and then after that comes the judgment. It is appointed once for you to die, and then after that comes the judgment of God. You got a short time period to live your life here. Yet when death comes, your time of living in this world is over with. And if you reject God's salvation that comes through the atonement of the Lord Jesus Christ, my friend, I'm here to tell you, you're going to hell. You're going to be judged. You're going to die in this life, and you're going to open your eyes up in the torments of hell. It's just like the rich man in the story that Jesus gave us. There was a rich man and there was a poor man named Lazarus. The rich man died. He lived for himself. He chased the love of money. He probably was a drunkard. He did what he wanted to do in life. He didn't care about God. And when he died, the Bible says he opened up his eyes in hell. And he remembered his life. And my friends, I'm warning you today that if you die without the salvation of God and you go to hell, you're going to remember this preacher standing on the street corner preaching to you, telling you to get right with God, turn to Jesus, don't go to hell. You're going to remember all the times that you had an opportunity to repent, but you rejected God's salvation, and you're going to live with that torment forever. You're going to be tormented and punished in the judgment of hellfire. And the Bible says the smoke of your torment is going to go up forever and ever. Yet you don't have to be judged by God. You don't have to go to hell. God is offering mercy to you. You don't have to be like the rich man that rejected God and lived ungodly and he died and went to hell. You can get right with God and repent and believe the gospel. You can repent and get real with the Lord and stop playing games with your life. For God sent his son Jesus into the world, not to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. See, the world is under judgment because of sin. The world is already condemned because of the iniquity and the rebellion of the people. And your only way of salvation is Jesus. For there is no other name given amongst men that we can be saved, but it's only through Jesus. Yet you have to humble yourself and repent. You have to turn to the Lord and truly come to God with your heart. The Bible says that if you confess the Lord Jesus with your mouth and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Ma'am, get right with God.
Amen.
Turn to the Lord.
You need to call
him. And If you believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. Yet you have to be willing to come to Jesus. You have to be willing to repent. Jesus said, so likewise, sir, if you do not repent, you're going to perish. That means you're going to go to hell. And sir, you're getting old. Think about your soul, because time is running out for you. There's a lot of people that are getting old and they don't know God. They're still living in their sin and they have not repented and they have not been born again. And my friends, I'm telling you that death is coming to us all. That there's a day that you're going to die and you're going to be judged by God. God bless you, ma'am. And God is offering you a pardon for your sins.